Imagine a star so massive that if you placed it where our sun is, it would swallow up every planet in our entire solar system. Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, all of it, like they were marbles falling into a cosmic void. Well, that's not science fiction, that's reality. Stars come in all sizes, from small red dwarfs to absolutely colossal giants that defy our ability to even comprehend their scale. And today, we're counting down the 10 biggest stars we've ever discovered in the universe. But here's the wild part. Even scientists are still debating which one actually deserves the top spot. So if you want to find out which cosmic monster takes the crown, stick around until the very end. Before we dive in, let's talk about what makes a star big. When astronomers measure the size of stars, they're looking at diameter, literally how wide they are. They compare everything to our sun, which they call one solar radius or one solar unit. The sun is already pretty huge. You could fit about 1.3 million Earths inside it. But the stars we're about to talk about, they make our sun look like a grain of sand on a cosmic beach. Now, when we say biggest, we're primarily talking about diameter, though we should mention that size doesn't always equal brightness or mass. Some of these giants are what we call red supergiants or hypergiant stars. They're cool on the surface compared to other stars, but they're absolutely enormous. They're like cosmic puffballs, bloated and unstable. Some have been called the puffiest stars in the galaxy, with atmospheres so loose and wispy that material is constantly streaming off into space. So grab your space helmet because we're about to take a tour of the universe's most extreme stellar titans. Starting our countdown at number 10, we have Mu Cephei, also known as the Garnet Star because of its stunning, deep red color. Located in the constellation Cepheus, about 5,500 light years away from us, this red supergiant is a cosmic jewel. Mu Cephei measures about 1,420 solar radii in diameter. To put that another way, if you could somehow unfold it into a flat surface, it would cover an area roughly the size of the distance from Earth to our Sun and back. This star is so huge that if it were placed where our Sun currently sits, its surface would almost reach the orbit of Jupiter. What's really fascinating about Mu Cephei is that it's not stable. We see it change brightness over time, which suggests it's pulsating like a cosmic heartbeat. It's in its death throes, literally. The star is burning through its fuel at an incredible rate and will eventually explode as a supernova, but that's still thousands of years away. For now, it remains one of the most visually striking red giants in the entire galaxy. At number 9, we have Betelgeuse, one of the most famous stars in the night sky. You might recognize this name as the violent demon from that horror movie, but the star itself is far more mysterious and dangerous than any Hollywood creation. Betelgeuse sits in the constellation Orion and is about 700 light years away from us. This red supergiant has been measured at approximately 1,440 solar radii, making it absolutely massive. But here's where Betelgeuse becomes really exciting. It's unstable in ways that keep astronomers on high alert. In 2019 and 2020, Betelgeuse did something unusual. It dimmed significantly, much more than it normally does in its regular pulsation cycle. Some scientists wondered if it was about to explode. It didn't. But when Betelgeuse does eventually go supernova, and it will, probably within the next 100,000 years or so, it will be visible in broad daylight for weeks. It'll be the brightest thing in Earth's sky, besides the sun. That's something to think about. A star that you can see from your backyard right now could detonate into cosmic oblivion any moment in astronomical terms. Number 8 is VV Cephei A, one of the most mysterious and unusual stars we're counting down today. Located in the constellation Cepheus, approximately 3,700 light years away, VV Cephei A is classified as a red hypergiant, the rarest and most extreme type of giant star. This star measures roughly 1,450 solar radii in diameter. That's bigger than Betelgeuse. But what makes VV Cephei A truly extraordinary is that it's a part of a binary system, which means it has a companion star orbiting very close to it. In fact, these two stars are so close that material from VV Cephei A is actually being pulled away by its companion's gravity, creating what we call an accretion disk. Essentially, one star is slowly cannibalizing the other. It's cosmic horror and beauty all rolled into one. What fascinates astronomers most is that VV Cephei A is so puffy and bloated that its outer atmosphere extends almost all the way to its companion star. We're talking about a star so enormous that its atmosphere takes up the space between two stars. It's mind-bendingly massive. Moving into the top seven, we arrive at Westerlin 126, a star so incredibly huge that it sits within a star cluster called Westerlin 1, located about 19,000 light-years away in the constellation Ara. Westerlin 126 is estimated to be around 1,530 solar radii in diameter. This is a red supergiant that exists in one of the most densely populated stellar nurseries we've ever found. The entire cluster is packed with some of the most massive stars in our galaxy, and Westerlin 126 is one of the crown jewels. Here's what makes this star stand out. It's not just massive, it's also incredibly active. Material is constantly streaming off its surface into space, creating a kind of stellar wind that's truly cosmic in scale. The star is losing mass at an astonishing rate. Some estimates suggest that Westerlin 126 is losing the equivalent of Earth's mass every few years. It's burning through its fuel and shedding its outer layers, heading inevitably toward a spectacular death. Some scientists even think it might go supernova before it has a chance to collapse into its own gravity well and form a black hole. At number 6, we have KY Cygni, a red hypergiant lurking in the constellation Cygnus, about 5,200 light-years from Earth. This star is often overlooked in discussions about stellar giants, but it absolutely deserves to be here. KY Cygni is thought to measure around 1,630 solar radii in diameter. Like many of the giants on this list, it's a red supergiant that's already well into its old age. The star has been measured multiple times over the decades, and measurements vary. Sometimes it seems smaller, sometimes larger, because its atmosphere is so chaotic and turbulent that it's genuinely difficult to determine where the star actually ends. What's remarkable about KY Cygni is its invisibility to the naked eye. Despite being so enormous, it's too far away and too faint to see without a telescope. Yet, if it were as close to Earth as Betelgeuse, it would dominate the entire night sky and would be visible during daylight hours. This star is a perfect reminder that size and visibility are two completely different things in astronomy. Number 5 is where things get really extreme. This is WOH G64, a red hypergiant located in the Large Magellanic Cloud, which is a satellite galaxy orbiting the Milky Way, about 160,000 light-years away. WOH G64 is estimated to measure approximately 1,540 to 1,650 solar radii in diameter, though measurements vary because, you guessed it, this star's atmosphere is incredibly unstable and chaotic. This is one of the most massive and most luminous red hypergiants ever discovered outside our own galaxy. Here's something cool to think about. WOH G64 is so enormous and so unstable that it's genuinely difficult to study. It's surrounded by an incredibly dense shell of ejected material, making it one of the dustiest and most shrouded massive stars we know of. When astronomers look at WOH G64, they're essentially trying to peer through a cosmic veil of the star's own remains. Everything about this star is extreme, dramatic, and unstable. It's a star living on the absolute edge of destruction. By the way, which of these stellar giants has surprised you the most so far? Comment down below and let me know which one blew your mind. And if you haven't already, smash that subscribe button and hit the notification bell so you never miss our cosmic explorations. Let's keep this journey through the universe going together. Number 4 is RW Cephei, another red hypergiant located in the constellation Cepheus, roughly 19,000 light-years away. This star is consistently listed as one of the absolute largest stars in the entire galaxy. RW Cephei measures approximately 1,650 solar radii in diameter. That means this single star is so wide that if you placed it at the center of our solar system, its surface would extend well past the orbit of Jupiter. To give you another comparison, you could fit about 5 billion suns inside this star. Let that sink in for a moment. What makes RW Cephei truly fascinating is that it's relatively well studied compared to many other hypergiants, which means we know more about its behavior and evolution. Astronomers have been monitoring it for decades, watching it fluctuate in brightness and size. The star is rapidly losing mass through its stellar wind, ejecting billions of tons of material into space every single year. This is a star in its final death throes, though final in astronomical terms means we're still talking about timescales of thousands or even millions of years. And now, number 3. This is UI Scuti, located in the constellation Scutum, roughly 9,500 light-years away. For a long time, this star held the unofficial title of largest star in the universe, and it still might. UI Scuti is estimated to be around 1,700 solar radii in diameter. Some measurements have put it even larger. This red hypergiant is so monumentally vast that it challenges our ability to comprehend size. If you were to somehow travel at light speed, the fastest speed anything can travel in the universe, from the center of UI Scuti to its surface, it would take you about 13 seconds. 13 seconds at the speed of light, just to cross from the middle of a star to its edge. Our solar system would fit inside the star like a piece of candy inside a warehouse. UI Scuti is a star made of fire and chaos. Its surface is incredibly turbulent, with regions of material constantly rising and falling. The star is losing mass at an astronomical rate, with stellar winds ripping its outer layers away and scattering them across space. Everything about UI Scuti is extreme. It's incredibly rare, incredibly massive, and astronomers still aren't entirely certain how it even exists or how it's managed to grow so large. It defies many of our models of stellar evolution. At number 2, we have VY Canis Majoris, one of the most famous supergiant stars in the galaxy. Located in the constellation Canis Major, about 4,900 light-years away, this star has captivated astronomers and space enthusiasts alike. VY Canis Majoris is measured at approximately 1420 to 1540 solar radii. But what really sets VY Canis Majoris apart is its instability. This star doesn't just pulsate, it erupts. There's evidence that VY Canis Majoris has undergone massive outbursts, ejecting tremendous amounts of material into space in sudden, violent explosions. These eruptions are thought to be triggered by internal instabilities that cause the star to literally convulse. It's a star hanging on by a thread, on the verge of catastrophe at any moment. And now, the moment you've been waiting for. Number 1, Stevenson 218, the largest star we've ever discovered. Stevenson 218 is a red hypergiant located in the constellation Scutum, part of a massive star cluster called Stevenson 2, approximately 19,000 light-years away. And this star is absolutely mind-bogglingly enormous. Stevenson 218 is estimated to measure between 2150 and 2220 solar radii in diameter. That means it's roughly 40% larger than UI Scuti. This star is so gigantic that if you could somehow compress it to have the same density as water, it would still be the size of our entire solar system. The entire solar system, Sun, Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, all of it, would fit inside this single star with room to spare. Here's the truly mind-bending part. Stevenson 218 is so enormous that its gravity is actually quite weak at the surface. Despite being thousands of times more massive than our Sun, its surface gravity is barely stronger than Earth's. This is because all that mass is spread out over such an incomprehensibly vast area. You could literally float on the surface of this star. Of course, the temperature would be about 3200 Kelvin, hot enough to vaporize you instantly, But gravitationally speaking, you could stand there. Well, technically. Stevenson 218 is also losing mass at a rate that's almost beyond comprehension. The stellar wind coming off this star is so powerful and so dense that it's actually creating an expanding nebula of ejected material around it. Astronomers believe that Stevenson 218 might not have more than a few hundred thousand years left before it collapses into a red dwarf or explodes as a supernova. In cosmic terms, this star is living out its final days, even though those final days stretch across epochs and millennia. Thank you for joining me on this cosmic journey through the biggest stars in the universe. If you enjoyed this exploration into the extreme, please like this video and subscribe for more mind-bending space content. Drop a comment below and tell me which star amazed you the most. And if you have any questions or want me to explore more cosmic mysteries, let me know in the comments as well. Until next time, keep looking up at the stars and keep wondering. The universe is waiting.